Hello, I'm Frankie Koopman. I'm an agricultural advisor for INAGRO. That's a practical research center in Belgium. I want to tell you something about our project, Inter-Nordsee Region project Carbon Farming. Carbon farming basically means to return and focus on the soil fertility, and this is what we have done within our Inter-Nordsee Region project. The focus is on potential of plants to reduce and store atmospheric CO2 and the role of the soils as carbon sink. To pursue this path, farmers need to reintegrate and maintain appropriate measures in their production. Therefore, first, a general list of 14 accepted agricultural measures to store carbon and corresponding carbon sequestration is made up by the different project partners in the EU region. Out of that, a regional promising top five is selected, taking into account which topic can easily be done by the farmers and also taking into account which measure can contribute a lot. By example, because there's a lot of surface of uncertain crop in that region. This is turned into practical info sheets as seen on the right of the screen. The problem is that a lot of the agriculture measures cannot be seen by human eye. Therefore, within the project, we wanted to make the measures more visible by making fact sheets, video, interviews, and so on. This can be found on the INAGRO website in Dutch and English. For example, also a storyboard about carbon farming, or more general information in English is available on the North Sea Region website. As carbon content in the soil is something where changes can be measured over long term, we are approaching it in the project by reporting the effort and not only the measure of the result. By this, also farmers who are already doing it well are recognized to keep up the good work. Within the project, we want to avoid that good practices will become obligatory. Therefore, a financial stimulus to keep up good work and stimulate small adaptation in daily work. The first showcase carried out in Belgium is located in the municipality of Beernem. This municipality has its own lands, and farmers can rent it for free if they apply carbon farming techniques. By this, the municipality can compensate the emission of several cars of the municipality by taking carbon sequestration measures on a small 10 hectares. By doing this, almost 5 tons of carbon is yearly sequestrated in the soil. A link to the video, part in English and part in Dutch, is mentioned on the screen. It becomes increasingly clear which carbon techniques have been the biggest potential of improving carbon sequestration on agricultural soils, and this potential and suitability of the different techniques is region specific. To push these techniques successfully into practice, significant return on investment has to be guaranteed for farmers and other stakeholders investing time and money in these techniques. Therefore, economic and ecological viable business models are indispensable. The results of an elaborated this study identifying existing business models and that can be used as an example and source of inspiration for future similar initiatives can be found here. I will give a short summary of the four categories of business models identified. First, we have models within the agri-food chain, often enterprises from within the agri-food sectors, such as processors or milk and vegetables, retailers, distributors, and so on. Are the ones taking initiative to make their business model sustainable. To achieve this, they are starting cooperatives with farmers applying successful carbon sequestration techniques. Companies can use this approach in a convenient way in their marketing campaigns, for example, by mentioning it on the packaging of their products. In this way, they illustrate to their consumers how they can contributing to the climate change challenge the agri-food sector is facing, and at the same time, they increase the awareness among consumers concerning the needs for more sustainable food production. The added value of their products can then partly flows to the farmers receiving a higher price for their products or receiving a direct payment for their additional efforts. Second models outside the agri-food chain, more and more companies and organizations focus on climate and sustainability in their business model. These are not necessarily active within the agri-food sector itself. A lot of them are already increasing their efforts in terms of sustainability, but sometimes it's impossible for them to become climate neutral due to the inevitable emissions. Some of these companies are looking for alternatives to compensate of their emissions possibilities and endless and depends on the creativity of the company. A commonly applied model these days is, for example, planting trees or investing in more sustainable energy production use and developing countries. However, there are also opportunities on the local scale within the agri-food sector. Companies can make a carbon agreement with the farmer and invest in the ways for the farmer to take actions in sequestration carbon, such as soil enhancement techniques. In return, the company is allowed to claim the additionality. Additionally, sequestrated carbon. Third, our models at farm level. Farmers can also take initiatives to make their products more sustainable by themselves without involvement of any other stakeholder. In most cases, farmers focus on the story behind their products, and they are selling their labeled products through short chain marketing. By openly communicating on their sustainable farming techniques towards their customers, they count on the increasing willingness of a consumer to pay a little extra for their sustainable products. A classic and generally known example of such a business model is the organic label. Finally, there are models including government institutions. Climate mitigation and adaptation is high on the agenda of national and regional governments. Also, a lot of municipalities, for example, from B&M, also province, cities, and so on, are developing climate action plans to compensate their emissions. Deprecation of the carbon farming is therefore often actively promoted by government institutions. Two main strategies can be defined. First, when proven beneficial for the society and environment, governments can pay farmers directly for the ecosystem services they are providing as a consequence of their sustainable farming techniques. Second, systems where the government is intervening in carbon credits trading and the follow-up of the efforts by farmers in terms of carbon storage are another viable option. These systems allow farmers to design their own projects aiming at increasing carbon storage. Following approval of their project, farmers can then receive carbon credits, which they can sell to companies or organizations looking for an alternative way to compensate for their carbon emissions. In both cases, government would be promoting the implementation of the sustainable carbon sequestration techniques in modern farming. Another interesting route to be explored for the future is the common agricultural policy that can create incentives for farmers through legislation or funding, stimulating carbon sequestration techniques. The policy will play a fundamental role in developing a fully sustainable agricultural sector that supports, for example, the environmental care and climate change actions. The drivers and incentives that may contribute to foster the adoption of practices on carbon neutral agriculture are first creating support in the agricultural sector. Farmers have to could be convinced that carbon farming techniques are good initiatives for their soils and that they can solve bigger emission problems. Besides farmers, also politicians have to be convinced that by stimulating legislation, farmers are willing or be willing to take carbon farming measures. In the project, we seek for the pioneers who are willing to take those measures on their fields. And in collaboration with our research station in Agro, we are demonstrating the good practices. The first steps are taken to contribute a role to the farmer. It's important to communicate that daily practices are relevant to store carbon in the soil. For the civilian, we have to show that not only trees are carbon stockage, but also good agricultural practices can contribute to reduce the CO2 amounts. By setting up the first showcases, interests are rising to set up a framework where farmers have a significant role in the carbon farming story, and also regional legislation will have to follow the current actoral practices. Thank you a lot for your attention.